Wake up, Cougars. Hello, I am Taylor Young Bottomley.
And I am Isaiah Rivera. Today you're wondering that, you know, why is it on a Monday, not a Friday? Well, we didn't have school last Friday, so we're doing a special today. First off, let's hear about the winner of last week's question, right?
Yeah, it was a Keystone contest that was announced by our wonderful editor, Steven.
Yeah, well, if you don't know, the question is, which statement best compares the energy transformation of photosynthesis and cellular respiration? The four choices are A, only photosynthesis uses oxygen to create energy. B, only photosynthesis causes an increase in kinetic energy. C, photosynthesis and cellular respiration both store energy in chemical bonds. And D, photosynthesis and cellular respiration both require chemical energy to make food. Now, what is the answer?
I think the answer is E, right? It's photosynthesis and cellular respiration have everything in common because science.
Wrong.
Aww.
The correct answer is C. Who got the correct answer?
Well, Celine Podlesny got it way better than I did.
Well, we're going to start off by saying, since Earth Day is tomorrow, we're going to say things you recycle to make the planet better.
To begin with, you might not have known that you can recycle your old, sweaty, you don't want shoes. And these shoes can be used to make outside basketball courts. So when you're running outside playing basketball with all your friends, just remember, your sweaty shoes are being on top of other people's sweaty shoes.
Scary.
Yeah.
Now let's go off to the cast, who did a beautiful job on 10 things you can do to make Earth better.
Everyone?
Number 1. Slow the flow. A faucet leaking just one drop per second wastes over 1,300 gallons per year. A leak from a hot water source wastes both water and fossil fuel, creating more greenhouse gases. Most repairs to plumbing fixtures pay for themselves within just 1 year. Fix it!
Number 2. Think green when you clean. Cleaning products that contain chlorine or petroleum distillates expose your family to toxins and then end up in the ecosystem. Choose non-toxic, naturally derived cleaning products, which are proven effective but won't cause long-term damage on the earth.
Number 3. Choose both sides. Every year, pulp mills release over 1 trillion gallons of chlorine-tainted water as part of the paper-making process. Using the other side of the paper can, cut that pollution almost in half, and choose recycled paper, especially processed chlorine-free recycled paper.
Number 4. Green your machine. Americans waste over 700 million gallons of gasoline each year just because tires aren't properly inflated. Millions more are wasted because our vehicles aren't properly tuned up. Keep your machine running green. You'll save more money and reduce emissions.
Number 5. Meat less for dinner. Once a week, plan a meat alternative for dinner. Enjoy pasta with a marinara or Alfredo sauce, meatless chili burritos, or even grilled veggie burgers. Reducing meat consumption conserves fresh water, saves topsoil, and even reduces air pollution.
Walk, hike, ride a bike. If people in the U.S. would occasionally ride a bike for a short errand instead of driving a car, over 70 million gallons of fuel could be saved each year. And there's the added benefit of enjoying the fresh air and exercise. For short errands, take a hike.
Number 7. Plant a tree every Earth Day. Over a 50-year lifetime, a tree generates $31,250 worth of oxygen, provides $62,000 worth of air pollution control, recycles $37,500 worth of water, and controls $31,250 worth of soil erosion. It also provides shade that keeps homes and cities cooler.
Give weeds a hand. Herbicides are the only way to control weeds, and they're certainly not the most environmentally friendly way. Invest in a good pair of gloves and garden tools, and remove weeds by hand. Also, choose natural alternatives to pesticides for getting rid of pests.
Number 9. Lighten your energy bill. There's a brighter way to light your home. New compact fluorescent lamps, CFLs. Compared to regular bulbs, CFLs last 10 times longer, use only 1/4 the energy bill, and produce 90% less heat. Yet they produce more light per watt. Brighten the future. Go CFL.
Number 10. Reduce, reuse, recycle. It's more than just a slogan. You can start making the world a greener place today. Return hangers to the cleaners. Donate clothing and computers to charities. Pack lunches in reusable containers instead of bags. There are hundreds of easy things to do. It's up to you.
So Earth Day started on April 22nd, 1970. and it has been a very important day to Americans ever since. It is a day to think back on what we do to our planet, our environment, and how we can keep them healthy.
Yes, well, after the first day in 1970, a lot of stuff happened. There was the EPA, or EPA, that was established in 1970.
You might know the EPA from the Simpsons movie. Remember how they were always going, EPA! EPA!
The Tough Clean Air Act of 1970 was passed with only a handful of dissenting votes. Well, let's go to Chris and find out what we can do for Earth Day.
Do we only have to do it on Earth Day?
No, we can do it every day. Chris?
What can you do to help save our environment? Earth is the only planet we have to call home. Since we live here, it is our responsibility to care for our living environment by keeping it clean and reducing pollution. Here are just a few ideas to put into practice to help save our environment on Earth Day and every day. Become better informed. Some simple ideas to get started off with Earth Day include: get in the habit of turning off lights, computers, and appliances when they are not in use. Replace standard light bulbs with energy-efficient fluorescent bulbs to reduce carbon dioxide emissions. Buy energy-efficient households, appliances, and yard tools. Switch from chemical-type cleaners to natural products like vinegar, baking soda, soap, and water. Keep your car tuned and leak-free, and dispose of used motor oil and cooling fluids at designated recycling centers. Keep tires properly inflated. Try using mass transit, carpooling, walking, or riding a bike as often as possible. Do not let the water run wastefully. Water the lawn in the early morning or late afternoon. Run washing machines and dishwashers only when full. Repair leaky pipes, faucets, and toilets. Purchase products that contain recycled content materials as often as possible. Reduce the amount of plastic bags that pollute the environment by purchasing reusable bags for your shopping. Any plastic bags you do get can be returned to the stores and placed in recycle bins, or you can reuse them for small garbage pail linings. The more you know, the greener you'll be.
So, you may have heard me mention our wonderful editor, Steven, who happens to be sitting right over there.
So let's go to Steven for the Keystone Contest.
Steven?
This is the Keystone Contest. We will have a Keystone question posted with the morning show every Friday until the time of the Keystones. We will rotate through biology, algebra, and literature questions. We will give the questions during the morning show every Friday, and then it will be posted in the Wake Up Cougars class in blended schools. Students can post their answers with the contest button. Every student that gets the answer right will be placed into a drawing to win a prize of a $15 lunch from Vesuvio's the following Friday. The winner will be announced on Thursday. Here is the question. Pam is playing with red and black marbles. The number of red marbles she has is 3 more than twice the number of black marbles. She has 42 marbles in all. How many red marbles does Pam have? Is it A, 13, B, 15, C, 29, or D, 33?
A Keystone Contest question will be posted with the morning show every Friday until the time of the Keystones. Questions will rotate through biology, algebra, and literature. We will give the question during the morning show every Friday, and then it will be posted in the Wake Up Cougars class in blended schools. Students can post their answers in the contest button. Every student with the correct answer will get placed in a drawing to win a prize of a $15 lunch from Vesuvio's the following Friday. Winner will be announced on Thursday. All judges' decisions are final. All rights reserved. No part of this may be reproduced, distributed, or transmitted in any form or by any means, including photocopying, recording, or other electronic or mechanical methods, without the express written consent of Mrs. Medic, except in the case of brief quotations embodied in critical reviews and certain other non-commercial uses permitted by copyright law.
And as always, wake up, Cougars!